Bessie Sharkey, film critic for the Los Angeles Times. I'm up in Toronto at the Film Festival, and we are here at the Lightbox, which is center of all the action. But I want to get serious for a moment. With serious so much on everyone's mind, I've been really drawn to stories, or actually films, of men at war. And instead of big global questions, they're really telescoping it down to the individual. And I want to talk about three specific films. The first is Canopy. It's set in World War II, and the filmmaker drops a soldier into the jungles of Singapore right in the middle of the war. He is by himself. He's in survival mode. It's a fearless film. There's virtually no dialogue. You feel the pulse of the soldier. You are there running through the jungle with him. It's really quite extraordinary. As quiet and as contemplative as Canopy is, Break Loose is brash and in your face. It's set in Russia in the waning days of the Yeltsin era, and it really follows four ex-soldiers who can't find anything else to do with their life but keep the violence going. Violence has become their trade. During the day, the heads that they are breaking are factory workers in rebellion. At night, they're at the disco. One of the key soldiers has the bad fortune of falling in love with the wrong girl. And the rest of the movie takes a look at whether ex-soldiers can ever find their way back to just normal. The final film is Omar, and it's by far the best. It's set on the West Bank, and honestly, it is an incredible love story, but there is so much brutality and so much violence. And the tension is set so tightly, you feel like you are in an occupied area where things can go wrong at any moment. And for Omar, unfortunately, they usually do. This is a man who is struggling to live. He wants to retain his dignity. He wants to just fall in love. It's not that easy, and it's a reminder that the legacy of war is deep. It's extraordinary storytelling, but it is the small picture, not the big picture, on the big screen. This is Bessie Sharkey, film critic for the Los Angeles Times.